Dude, that was a horrible experience. I mean, such a horrible experience. I mean, I don't even know what's going on lately with Madame Marie and the vampire. But, and my dream. You know, I was so curious about what was going on and all this other stuff. I mean, I'm trying to have my career and go to school, and the case of Miranda keeps coming back to me continually, always, never ending. I can't sleep. So I bought the book by David Lynch, and he had something to say on dreams. Well, let me see. Oh, dreams. Like, I can't be the only one who keeps having these dreams all the time. Okay, he says, I love dream logic. I just like the way dreams go. But I have hardly ever gotten ideas from dreams. I get more ideas from music or from just walking around. On Blue Velvet, though. I was really struggling with the script. I wrote 4 different drafts and had some problem with it near the end. Then one day, I was in the office and I was supposed to go in and meet somebody in the next office. Just kind of like how I was supposed to meet Madame Marie Massard. In that office that looked just like Gina's home. Wait a minute. No wonder everything looked familiar. Did I dream this or what? Anyway, a secretary was there and I asked her if I could have a piece of paper. Because I suddenly remembered that the night before I'd had this dream. And there it was. There was 3 little elements that solved those problems. That was the only time that's happened. Now, if I listen to David Lynch, the 3 elements, the vampire, the bite, and everything that's happened since then, I just don't know. I just really don't know. I just don't know what to do. I really have to think about this. I mean, is there a vampire? Who is everyone? I thought she was my cousin. She looked familiar and then she didn't look familiar. I mean, it's only been like 2 years since I've been out of school, so I don't know, I don't know. I just don't know anymore.
We'll be right back.